Indiana pioneer ancestors were men and women of courage and ingenuity. Learning more about these pioneers teaches us not only about our state's colorful history, but also about ourselves as individuals and as citizens of a great state. The Society of Indiana Pioneers is dedicated to honoring the memory and work of our pioneer ancestors. The Society pays homage to our Hoosier ancestors through educational opportunities, travel, the arts, and genealogical research. The Society offers men, women, boys, and girls the chance to explore and to celebrate their ancestry in an atmosphere of discovery, friendship, and fun. Why is it important to learn about our pioneer ancestors?
When you do your research and learn about your family, it enriches your life because you look and you can find out all kinds of things that you didn't know about your family. I think Alex Haley one time said in the book Roots that we all have a longing to know where we came from, who we are, and there's a vacuum until that's filled. The Society of Indiana Pioneers can help you learn about your family. It can help you document it, and it can help you put the past with the present.
The first city that was settled and still survives in Indiana was Vincennes. Before that, before it became a settlement, it was an Indian village. It was named Chipkoke. That means place of roots. And all of us in Indiana have a Chipkoke, a place of roots. We want to hear about your family. They did something important. If they hadn't been here, you wouldn't be here. We're glad to have you, and we want to know about your ancestors.
Chuck Bragg enjoys learning about the life of his pioneer ancestors, particularly the clothing of the period.
The outfit that I have on is an exact replica of the clothes that they wore. We have the patterns from those outfits. The hat is authentic. In about 1830 to 1840, this hat became more like a stovepipe. But the early 1800s, this was the design of the hat.
2016 marked the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Society of Indiana Pioneers. To mark this occasion, we issued two publications, one an historical novel entitled Deep Forest, and the other a compilation of family stories submitted from all 92 counties entitled Pioneer Founders of Indiana. 2016 also marked the bicentennial of Indiana's statehood, and both of these publications received the coveted designation of Legacy Project by the Indiana Bicentennial Commission. The story behind Deep Forest is well-researched, based on solid facts of early Indiana history, and is now available for sale on the website of the Society of Indiana Pioneers, and all proceeds from the sale of the book go to the benefit of the Society. In the summer meeting of 2010, the Society's board determined to adopt an initiative to collect family stories of Indiana's early pioneers as a Pioneer Founders of Indiana project. When the project closed in 2015, over 500 submissions had been received, from the very famous, President William Henry Harrison, to the more humble, such as John Chapman, Allen County's Johnny Appleseed. The book was successfully published in 2016 and is now available on the Society's website.
History education is an important part of the Society's mission. School children who excel in Indiana junior history clubs are recognized by the Society each year. And the Society awards academic fellowships in higher education to further the study of their state's rich pioneer past.
The Society of Indiana Pioneers offers a couple of different awards each year. The first award I'd like to talk about is the History Fellowships. We offer $2,000 fellowships each year, one to a master's degree student and then one to a PhD dissertation. Those are for original research related to the pioneer history of Indiana history, which is prior to 1850. The second award that we offer is the John H. Holliday Junior History Award, which is a $500 award to a school, class, or organization that has helped expand knowledge within their local school of the pioneer period of Indiana history.
Topics have ranged very widely. There was research in slavery with regard to mid-19th century and early 19th century Indiana. Recollections and memories captured of Abraham Lincoln in southern Indiana, and the religious education of children in early Indiana. And this year, our recipient is someone who is looking at music in early middle Indiana, meaning central Indiana. And then once the thesis or the dissertation is completed, that a copy of that thesis or dissertation is deposited at the office of the Society of Indiana Pioneers.
Indiana became a state in 1816. The Society of Indiana Pioneers was founded in 1916. Since then, the Society has been active in placing historical markers throughout the state.
Since I've recently retired, I dug into family history and found that the Society of Indiana Pioneers was really an organization very much attuned to the kinds of things that I'm interested in and that really bring me back to Indiana to further explore my roots, and I'm loving it.
Some of the most educational and enjoyable benefits of the Society are the discoveries made on the semi-annual pilgrimages to historic sites around Indiana.
Well, we take two pilgrimages a year, one in the fall and one in the spring. Just like our ancestors, we enjoy exploration all over Indiana. We go to every corner of the state. Usually we're met by historic guides and escorts on sites. We've gone to the second largest natural lake in Indiana, Lake Massapequa, and the prestigious private school Culver on its shores. We've been to our territorial capital of Corydon and seen the reenactment of a historic slavery trial in early Indiana. We've been to our oldest village in Indiana, the city of Vincennes. So we really go all over the state.
It helped to validate who I am as a person because I was able to get membership through my great-great-great-grandmother who had come into Indiana about 1815. And many people, well, it is difficult for African Americans to learn about their ancestors. Most of them had their family names taken away. And this is an unusual instance where there's a lot of documentation on my family. So I was thrilled because I think I know more about who I am.
There are many benefits to being part of the Society of Indiana Pioneers. As a member, you receive Society publications such as the Pioneer Times newsletter and the Society Yearbook, which lists all members along with their pioneer ancestors. You get first priority on Society travel outings. But perhaps most important, membership gives you a chance to discover common backgrounds with other members at Society events. The events are a great place to make personal, business, and genealogical connections. In fact, the Society employs a part-time genealogist to assist members in discovering their personal heritage.
You know, if you think that you have any kind of roots in Indiana, you know, pioneer history, then I would recommend going to our website and entering your surname to see if any of their information might be available within our archives. Our office is located on the first floor of the Indiana State Library within the genealogy section. So I have access to census records, microfilm, all the county history, county records that are available within the library. Since 1916, we've had over 5,200 members apply for membership. And up to this date, we have about 8,400 ancestors that have been approved. So our archives are full, a rich, you know, rich block of Indiana genealogical history within our archives. I always kind of think of it as the best reality show that you can find available. It's your history, and what can be more better than that?
The Society of Indiana Pioneers has four levels of membership. Regular members are adults 18 and over who prove one or more of their ancestors were Indiana pioneers. With a few exceptions, a pioneer is one who lived within the present boundary of an Indiana county on or before 1840. If you think you didn't have an ancestor in the state by then, consider this.
Think of how many direct ancestors you had living in 1840. If you're a high school student today, you had 128 to 256 living ancestors in 1840. If you are a retired person, you would probably had 32 to 64 direct ancestors living in 1840. Any one of these living in Indiana by then could qualify you for membership in the Society of Indiana Pioneers, as long as documentation of your lineage can be found.
Junior members meet the same requirements as regular members, but are under the age of 18. What if you want to support and participate in the society, but you don't have an Indiana pioneer ancestor? Associate membership is a wonderful way for you to become involved with others who share an interest in the pioneer era of Indiana. The society also has an honorary membership for people who have made outstanding contributions to Indiana history. Recipients include Robert Todd Lincoln, President Benjamin Harrison, Indiana University history professor and author Dr. James Madison, and Evie Rhoda Hamill. She is the granddaughter of the Society's founder and served the Society for over 50 years. All membership benefits, levels, and fees are described in detail at our website.
The Society of Indiana Pioneers is an organization where we honor our ancestors who came to Indiana before 1840. We have 1,100 members currently. We have people that have one or two ancestors. We have members that have 30 and 40 ancestors, and one that even has more.
We understand our modern position in life today better when we understand that when we go through and see the lifestyles of the pioneers, their activities, their struggles, and victories. In the Society of Indiana Pioneers, our activities are attended by people like you and me. We go to the pilgrimages and have fun and the meetings and have fun because we all have an interest in state history.
We're the Miller family of Noblesville, Indiana. Our study of the families and our ancestors in the state of Indiana have given us an opportunity to learn more about the history of not only the state but our family. As part of our studies and involvement with the pioneers, we've gained a lot of information, but more than that, we've gained the camaraderie and relationships and friendships with all of the people involved in this organization who have great stories to tell. We hope you'll consider joining and spending time with us on pilgrimages and getting involved in Indiana history. Gentlemen, have you got anything to add?
Go Pioneers!